Welcome to A2S Learning. In this video, we will see how plants prepare their own food by the process called photosynthesis. As discussed in previous video, green plants are called autotrophs since they prepare their own food using the inorganic raw materials present in their surroundings by the process called photosynthesis. And this food is utilized by plant for various metabolic activities. In today's session, let us see what happens during the process of photosynthesis. The term photo means light and synthesis means building together. Thus, photosynthesis means building up with light. We can also define photosynthesis as the process by which green plants prepare their own food from carbon dioxide and water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll. The food prepared is in the form of glucose, which provides energy for the plant, and excess glucose is converted into starch and is stored in the leaves of plant. During this process, oxygen is given out by plants, which is used by other organisms for respiration. Site of photosynthesis. Chloroplasts are the site of photosynthesis. These chloroplasts are the green-colored plastids which are present in leaves. When we look into the cross-section of leaf, the middle layer contains photosynthetic cells called mesophyll cells. Mesophyll region is divided into two layers, that is palisade layer and spongy layer. Numerous chloroplasts are present in these mesophyll cells. These chloroplasts contain a green color pigment called chlorophyll, which absorbs the solar energy. Once solar energy is absorbed by chlorophyll, conversion of light energy into chemical energy and splitting of water molecules into hydrogen and oxygen takes place. Then the carbon dioxide is reduced to carbohydrates. These three steps usually occur one after the other, but they differ in few plants. For example, in desert plants, the carbon dioxide is taken at night to prepare an intermediate product which reacts with sunlight on next day when the stomata is open. Now let us see what is stomata and what is the role of stomata in photosynthesis. Stomata are the tiny pores present on the surface of the leaves. In land plants, stomata are present on the epidermal layers, while in aquatic plants it is absent. In land plants, the stomata helps in exchange of gases. The carbon dioxide required for photosynthesis enters through these stomata. But it is important to note here that exchange of gases can also occur through the surface of stems and roots. Loss of water also occurs through stomata. To prevent this, stomata closes when it does not require carbon dioxide for photosynthesis. This opening and closing of stomata is controlled by a pair of guard cells surrounding the stoma. The guard cells swell when water flows into them, causing the stomatal pore to open. Similarly, the pore closes when the guard cells loses water. Hence, we can conclude that stomata helps in movement of gases in and out of the plant cells. So that's it for this session. For more videos, please do like and subscribe to my channel.